Introducing the Gardner family. Daphne, Mary, Linda, Susie, and Lucille. Ready for action. And the Hartling family. Mickey, Sarah Jane, EJ, Bertha, and Wally. On your marks, let's start the Family Feud. With the star of Family Feud, Richard Dawson.
Thank you for watching. We had King Tut, the exhibit here. And I, how many people here? Because a lot of people probably from out of town. But applaud if you saw it, because it was magnificent. Yeah. Okay. Thank you. Just magic. And we all saw it, and we really loved it, and they held it over here. And I got a lovely letter here. It said, "Dear Mr. Dawson, I and my family have the pleasure to send you a gift, which I'm going to show you. Which camera so I can you can get ready? Which one shall I show it on? There?
Here.
There. Either or. By elimination. I pointed there and you went, okay, I'll show in a second. My family had this pleasure to give you the gift. It's the work of one of my Egyptian families. One of these gentlemen made this. We're very pleased, as you told all the American people, to visit King Tut exhibit. I wanted to come and thank you myself, but for many reasons I couldn't. And it's from Dallas, Texas, Samir Hashem. And I want you to just see, if you can, the beautiful workmanship in this. Can you see that? That's all copper inlaid. Come here, Lois. Kathy Johnson, come here. The lady in love with Egypt on our whole staff is a darling lady, oh, Kathy Johnson, and she's blushing. I'm going to sell you this for $4. Now, I know that you'll take care of that, okay? And Samir, it was just as though you made it for her, because she loves it so much. This will give you a chance to visit her. Shalom, may the peace be with you. Come in the first. Get out of here. Here are the winners, the Gardner. Hello. How are you? Gardner came and took us for $5,346. Let's meet them all.
On my right is Mary, my sister-in-law, Linda, my niece, Susie, my other niece, and my sister, Lucille.
Okay. Last time we were all together, they all cried, all of them. So we had about 15 seconds before we went off the air. I got a piece of Kleenex and started crying. I thought it'd be funny if we were all crying. As I lowered the Kleenex and looked up, they'd all put their Kleenex away and were just staring at me. I naturally look like a complete fool. Well, I want to thank you for that, ladies. I won't forget it. How are you? Where do you come from?
I come from Etna, California.
How many people there?
750.
Linda, you live there, Etna?
No, I live in Mount Shasta. It's about 60 miles from there.
Is it pretty?
Oh, it's
you have skiing
gorgeous.
There?
Yes.
Ski?
Oh, I tried it. All I did was lay on the ground all day and laugh.
Oh,
I really
did.
I watched.
Very similar to my first affair, if I recall. I wasn't the one laughing. The young lady was.
Can I just say...
Say any dumb
hello to my two boys with their father in Guam, Brooke and Brandon.
Are they in Guam?
Yes.
Well, yeah, we're seen in Guam. We're not understood, but we're seen.
I knew that...
Blowing the big kiss. There. There's little Susie. Are you going to take a trip around the world?
Yes.
Tell us about it.
I've been hired to work on a 62-foot sailboat, and it's a 3 to 5 year cruise, and we'll be gone, and we're going all over the world. Honolulu's first stop, so I hope this is shown in Honolulu, so I get to see myself. We have a TV on the boat, though.
So what are you going to do, though? Work as a deckhand?
Yeah, everything. We'll all take turns being cook. And
have you ever been to
sea? No.
I swear, I ran away to sea at the age of 14 and took a trip around the world that lasted 7 months and was seasick every day.
That's what my father says.
Oh, you're going to have some good times. Can't lose you. How you doing?
Good.
All right, here's the family
going to
tell you right now
son?
Called?
No.
Hartling. There you go. Very smart. Who you got with you?
Well, I've got my lovely wife, Sarah Jane.
Oh, I'm in love with her. Yes, I'm sorry.
The ever-present Ernie Merck, my brother-in-law. We call him Ege. Happy-go-lucky.
All right.
My mother, Bertha.
Hi.
And my father, Wally.
How are you, Wally?
I'm fine.
He's as deaf as a post. Speak up. What do you do?
I'm a land developer. I'm in real estate.
You look like an athlete.
Movie ex-athlete.
Oh, you are?
Ex-athlete, yes.
What did you do?
Played baseball.
For whom?
Played in the Dodger organization.
Did you really?
Sure did.
What were you, pitcher?
Catcher.
Catcher?
Yep.
Who's got the job now?
Yeager.
Yeah.
I played a lot.
They probably went alphabetical and backwards. That's how they you've got this lane. Hello.
Hi. That's for me, and this is... And Tammy?
He's very Corey. Big. Thank you.
Look out, Richard. Look out, Richard.
Well, I trust that she discussed that with you, did she?
Not at all.
Oh,
that's her own
be deal. Nice to her.
That's for my four daughters.
Oh, you have four daughters? Mike.
Wow.
Look at these angels.
It was easy.
Wow, easy. Can you see those? They
except
are
for
girls.
The last one, because she was supposed to be a boy. So it wasn't
you look like a little girl yourself. That is beautiful. What do you do, Ethan?
How do you do?
What do you do?
I own crowd management. We supply ushers, ticket takers, and ticket sellers to public events here in L.A.
Well, nobody's perfect.
Yeah. Oh, I want to show you this.
What do you got?
I had to show you these.
Well, these?
Don't get mad at me.
Where the? The end of the rainbow.
Those are good luck.
No, they are. Good luck. You got a butterfly there
this
for good luck?
For you.
For me?
For the refrigerator? It's got a magnet. I made that for you.
Did you really? I don't know if you can see that. Can you see that little butterfly?
Yes, yes.
This side? See how I take direction? That is gorgeous. Thank you, darling. Wally, we'll get on with it, shall we? Come on, let's play the feud. Let's do it. Come on, Angel. All righty, we surveyed 100 people. Top five answers on the board. You have to try and find the most popular answer. Here's the question. Name a woman who, now or in the past, headed a country. Yes, sir.
Golda Meir.
Golda Meir. Israel. You got it. One answer better than that, Daphne. Name a woman who, now or in the past, headed a country.
The Queen of England.
Would you accept that, sir?
No,
well, don't get testy. I just asked you. You're on the right track. I need a name for it, though.
Margaret.
Okay. You were that close.
I know.
Queen Margaret! You control it. What are you going to do?
Whatever
you want. Okay. Well, come over here. All right. You see, they wanted a name.
I know.
Name a woman who, now or in the past, headed a country.
Queen Elizabeth.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
All right, royal subjects, Queen Elizabeth.
Come on, Lindy.
Remind me to drop her a line because she'll be delighted to hear this.
Hi. How about Queen Victoria?
Right.
Yes. Good answer.
She was such a good sport. Queen Victoria. Yeah. Easy. Name a woman who, now or in the past, headed a country.
How about Mary, Queen of Scots?
Okay.
Yeah.
Good answer.
You
answer.
Like that?
Yes.
Mary, Queen of Scots, are you there? Couldn't get her kilt on in time. Okay. That's your first strike. Three strikes to lose control. The question they get a chance to steal.
Okay.
Lucille, what do you say?
Napoleon's Josephine.
Ah.
Did
she help him?
Good.
She did it. Yeah, she helped.
Yeah,
good one. All right. Josephine, up there. Not there.
She wasn't there.
She would just roll along. They got two strikes.
Okay, Daphne. Come on, Daphne.
Daphne, name a woman who, now or in the past, headed a country.
Queen Wilhelmina from Holland.
Right.
Wilhelmina. Right.
Oh,
right.
Yeah. Queen Wilhelmina is a very good answer, whether it's there or not. If it is, you're okay. If not, it's your third strike. And... Hartling's strategy will have paid off because they get a chance to steal. Queen, will I mean up? Not there. What do you say? Come on, Mick.
You got Wilhelmina, you got, come on.
How about the one from Argentina?
Perone, Perone. Perone.
Perone.
Need a
Perone.
Need a
Perone.
Need a name. Need a name.
Perone.
Eva Perone.
Okay, fine.
Sounds like a good one.
When you come up there and you say, you've got your Wilhelmina, and we've just had Wilhelmina over here, you're looking, he'll give you a little shot.
Yeah.
Start to give him that. Peron with Argentina, I believe. Right.
Right?
She's up there, you get the money. If not, the ladies get it. Even Peron!
Madam Sensei Chef, I don't...
What about the gander, you know, lady... Let's see, number three. Indira Gandhi. Did somebody... Did you say that?
Yeah.
And number four.
Cleopatra.
Cleopatra. My goodness me. She barged down the Nile and sank you. It was a nasty sight. We'll be back right after this. $76 right there. Nothing here. Come on, Angel. Come on, babe.
Hey.
100 people surveyed. Top five answers on the board. Here's the question. Name a sound that makes a driver sit up and take notice. Yeah.
An automobile horn.
Ah, the old horn.
Pardon
Check
me.
The Richter scale, will you? Automobile horn! Yes. Bye bye! What are you going to do? Play it? Hey! Yeah. Sure, you haven't done any mining? Sound that makes the driver sit up and take notice, Linda.
How about a siren?
Boy, yeah. You got to pull over and stop them, right? Because that's an emergency.
Right.
Siren! Very good. Who's saying, Don?
How about squealing brakes?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's
a
good one.
Yeah. Or DSB. Dreaded squealing brakes. 100 people surveyed, did any mention or even, well, I think mention, that's the proper word, is it? Refer to?
No. Come on.
Thank you. Acknowledge. Acknowledge. Another good word.
Right. Yeah.
Hurry. DSB, dreaded squealing brakes. They did! Luke, what do you say, Angel?
Repeat that one more time.
Of course I will. Name a sound that makes a driver sit up and take notice.
A crying child in the back seat.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
Good answer, Mom.
Good answer.
Particularly if you have no children at all. The dreaded crying child! Not there. That's your first strike. Daphne, my love?
What's that question? Repeat that question.
See, I can't say, where the hell they go? When I'm down there, I don't know. They go off and get coffee and stuff?
Yeah.
Name a sound that makes a driver sit up and take notice.
Train.
The
sound of a train.
Oh, yeah. All right.
Yeah.
Up a train.
That's a good one.
Good answer.
All right. Looking for a train. Not there. Second strike.
Oh,
what
come
do you
on,
say,
Mary.
Darling? You gave me that number one answer.
Give it to him, Mary.
Wait. No.
Sound?
Somebody yelling.
Okay.
Yeah.
Fine.
Good
all
answer.
Right.
Good
Somebody
answer.
Yelling's up there. You're all right. If not, it's your third strike. Hartling's didn't get a chance to steal. Sound of somebody yelling. You can give me it right now and get it all. Take a big lead in the game.
In my case,
yeah.
A little crunching of metal.
Yeah, that would make you, wouldn't it? Definitely.
It does, yeah. Make you sit right up and take notice.
The old crunching of metal is up there. Clean sweep. Right. You got it all and a big lead in the game. If not, get a chance to steal. Metal crunching!
No.
Very good. We'll be back right after this.
Deck and patio owners, stop struggling.
I just met Pancho's mom here. And my nose went $174, right? Nothing here.
This is a friend.
Sure. Dollar values are doubled. You win this, you go for the big money. You need to win it to get in the game. 100 people surveyed. Top four answers on the board. This is the question. Name a building at an airport. Great conversation. Yeah.
The restaurant at LAX.
All right. Restaurant, is it there? Not there. Darling, chance for you here. A building at an airport.
Restaurant.
That's what they just said.
3 seconds.
Oh, gosh.
Administration building.
All right, administration building.
How about the terminal?
Okay. Susie said, how about the terminal? There's the terminal there. Okay. Oh, I hate a news microphone. That's terrible. I'm sorry. Don't let the children see that. Oh, my. Have you no shame? Well done. Building at an airport.
A hangar.
Okay.
Great,
great. Still wants a hangar? Yeah. Woo! Thanks, Daphne. I'm going to go.
Come on,
Daphne. Daphne, building at an airport. 3 seconds on.
The ticket booth.
Okay. One ticket booth. Who's right? Mary?
Richard. Tower.
Ah.
Ah, very good.
Looking for a tower? Yes. One more minute now. A building at an airport.
How about the parking garage?
Okay.
Yes.
If it's
good
there,
answer.
There's a chance. Parking garage. Who's right? Susie, come on, darling.
Come on, you can do it.
Building at an airport.
How about the baggage claim room?
Okay.
Yeah.
Baggage claim room's there. You'll play for the big money. If not, it's your third strike. You got a chance to steal baggage claim room. You can get in the game, Mick. Come on.
The fire station at the airport.
Give me one, whatever you want to call it.
It's the fire station.
Okay. Fire station's up there. You're in this game. If not, you will have shut them out and you'll play for the big money. Yeah. Fire station! Number four, please.
The hotel and motel.
Right, the old hotel and motel. I know what you're... It's like being in the minors again, isn't it?
I'm right back from
the start. No, you're on television. You're going to get a job as an actor, you're so handsome. Oh, no. Got 3 years of pantyhose, you'll love that wallet. We thank you for being here.
Thanks a lot. We appreciate it.
Your family is gorgeous. Thank you. Take care. Bye, John. And I love my family. Thank you. Thank you. Who's going to play? Come on, let's go. You going first? All right. Let's see if they can do it. Twice in a row right after we watch this. Okay, ready?
Ready.
So you did it the last time. We got Lucille off. Can't hear. She has earphones on. I'll ask you 5 questions. Give me 5 answers in 15 seconds. Trying to think of the most popular one. You and Mama get 200 points. You got $5,000. 15 seconds. Darling, just this first question, just the first one, we asked 100 high school students. Name one thing you like to do most during the summer.
Swim.
A food used as a topping.
Sour cream.
An occupation that serves the public.
Policeman.
Something you serve in a pitcher.
Kool-Aid.
A furry animal.
Dog.
Turn around. Good job.
Nobody drinks Kool-Aid.
A lot of them do, let's say. We asked 100 kids, name something you like to do most during summer. You said? Swim, our survey said. 38. A food used as a topping, you said? Sour cream, our survey said. 0.
Oh, Zippo.
Yeah, an occupation that serves the public, you said? Policeman, our survey said. 42. Something you serve in a pitcher, you said? Kool-Aid, our survey said? 9. A furry animal, you said? A dog, our survey said? 7. You got 96. Clear the board. That's almost halfway there. Off you go. Here's Lucille. I'm going to ask you the same questions that I asked Linda. You cannot duplicate her answers. If you do, you hear this. I say try again. You give me another answer, okay? Line everyone, please. The answers Linda gave us. Give me 20 seconds on the clock, please. This very first question we asked 100 high school students. It's just the first question. We asked the 100 high school students, name one thing you like to do most during summer vacation.
The swing.
Try again.
To the mountains.
A food used as topping.
Whipped cream.
An occupation that serves the public.
Waitress.
Something you serve in a pitcher.
Orange juice.
A furry animal.
Dog.
Try again.
Cat.
Cat? Thank you. Turn around. We asked one kid names that you like to do during the summer. You said mountains, our survey said. Oh. Go to the beach, swim, number one answer. Food used as topping. You said whipped cream, our survey said. 50. That's the number one answer. An occupation that serves the public. You said waitress, our survey said. 7. Policeman, number one answer. You are 43 points away. Something you serve in a pitcher. You said orange juice, our survey said. 3. Lemonade was the number one answer. You need 40 points for $5,000, a furry animal. You said cat, our survey said. 26. Bear was the number one, but you got 186, $5 for every point, a total of 930, and we got this. Love ya. See you here on the Family Feud.
Some departing contestants receive from Copper Tone a complete selection of tanning products, one for every complexion. For the tan people, notice Copper Tone. And jewelry from Sarah Coventry, who has jewelry with fashion know-how for every occasion. Versatile, fashionable Sarah Coventry jewelry sold at home fashion shows. And the cooler in the supply of fresh with a surprising taste of fresh tart tingly and sugar-free too. Wow! And prune trees quickly and safely with these pruners and loppers from JCPenney. Coated with Teflon S for easier, cleaner cutting. This is Gene Woods speaking for Family Feud. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman Productions.